Yo, Chungus Malungus 27 here with another guy. This time we are looking at Hood Old F. You know what? You read the title. You know what this is about. This is about being a one-trick pony with Robin. So let's get to it. Now let's start with the toolkit that's available to us. First of all is the ability, that's an explosive arrow. You just charge it up by getting assassinations and it looks something like this. It does AoE damage, which means that it's gonna kill everybody near it, and it can also be stuck to targets. Moving on to the gear, we have the flashbang available. It looks something like this. It's mostly used against NPCs when you are trying to run away, but it can also help you out quite a lot in breaking team fights and providing support. You can also blind people and just kill them as well. But the thing is, right now there's no animation for players being flashed. So for example, if you're trying to flash an enemy player, you won't see if he was flashed or not. It's something that the developers, in my opinion, should look into, but I guess we'll see if they actually do anything about it. Moving on to the trait available to us. This one is basically just increasing the time a player is tagged when tagged by the Robin. Basically, it increases the time you see the player through walls and such. It's not really that big of a deal, the increase isn't that big, but it is decent, I guess. It's some. I like to build the Robin for range and accuracy. I don't really believe in the whole close range Robin. So for that, we are taking Reticent Recon. That means that you're gonna cap points faster and you're also gonna climb ladders and other stuff way faster. This helps you to get to advantage points, and basically for me right now, Robin is played as a support. The idea is that you can get to those high places way easier, and that way you can support your whole team and provide valuable information. So this perk is really good. The other two, in my opinion, aren't that good. The one downside to this perk is the fact that your winching is way slower, but in my opinion, Robin shouldn't be winching in the first place, because you're basically trying to defend when your team is winching. So if somebody comes in, you have to headshot and basically keep them away from the winching place. For the second perk, I'm taking Bodkin Point. This increases speed and also range of the arrow. In my opinion, this is much better than the other variant, even though that one is also a good idea. The reason I'm using this is because I'm usually going for long shot headshots, and making a headshot is way easier when your arrow actually goes directly wherever you point, instead of having that arch. The downside of this perk is the fact that your arrows break upon impact, but the thing is, if you know where your arrow boxes are, you're not really gonna run out of arrows. Personally, I don't really run out of arrows that often, but there has been some times when I did. The second option I can recommend is Broadhead. Broadhead increases your damage when firing a charged shot. However, it also means that your arrows will not break, which can be useful in some situations, I guess. Weapon accuracy, however, over short range is reduced, and your quick fire shots deal way less damage. The damage boost is quite visible. You can see it in the future clip in a second here, but in my opinion, this one isn't really worth it compared to the other one, because the other one is basically helping you get a headshot, and headshots usually one shot anyway. So instead of getting two shots in with this one in the body shot, you can just get a headshot instead, and you know, just click heads, get killed. Now here's an example of the Bodkin arrow. As you can see, the travel speed is way faster and you can better actually hit marks from a distance. As you can see, there's barely any drop when you shoot. It goes kind of like a bullet, honestly. And it's just much easier and much cleaner to get headshots with this. Now here is the same perk with body shots. It does a bit more than half the HP of a target dummy. Too bad we don't actually have numbers in the game yet, so we could better compare, but in the end it is what it is. Now looking at the broadhead arrow, you are gonna see the drop in the velocity of the arrow. So basically, unlike the previous perk that I'm actually using, the drop actually is visible and you have to account for it whenever you go for long shots. This is not really game breaking or even like making the perk useless, it's just that you have an extra thing to keep in mind. In my opinion, I just prefer the other one because I'm going for headshots anyway and I like it easy. As you can see, the body shot damage is considerably higher, and this will definitely help you in closer range encounters, but in my opinion, it's still not as good as the other one. You can play around with it and just get good with the arch, but yeah. Moving on to the ability, I'm taking Mercurial Arrow. This is basically because it's making the arrow actually explode instantly instead of having to wait for it, and that way is making the ability much, much harder to dodge. The thing is that you're gonna have a harder time hitting it because of the massive drop whenever you do actually fire the ability. You will see in a second. In this clip, we are gonna go for the target furthest away from us. So basically, we are gonna have to account for the fact the arrow will have an arch. So we are gonna aim at the top and see where it lands. Yeah, I know, there's a lot of geometry involved in this one, but this is only for the long shots and the shots that actually make you feel like a legendary Hanzo main. Now, most of the time, your shots are gonna be something like this. When used properly, this is basically a I win button. It wins team fights and it can help your team get to the chest or clear a chest or so on and so forth. There's a lot of things you can do with this. I personally also use this ability to get a John off me or people that are really close to you and you really don't have a lot to do. The thing with Robin is the fact that you actually have really hard time when fighting in close range. This ability means that you can basically just shoot it down at the floor and get the kill so you can move on. Speaking of moving on, let's move on to a scenario or a scene from a match so I can better explain to you basically what you should be going for when you're having a Robin match and what your position should be and so on and so forth. This is the graveyard and this map is basically Robin Heaven at the docks. This way you can actually sit on top of the church and you can go for kills and area denial by just sitting here and taking pot shots. This allows your the rest of your team to actually go in for the winch or just go in for the kills on the enemies that are stuck behind walls or behind other things because of your massive area denial with this shot. Not only that, but you also have a good overview of the battlefield. All the time I'm trying to go for this type of position so I can give information to my team and also be safe from melee fighters like John and so on. As I said before, I don't believe that Robin should be the one winching, but he's really helpful when you're actually sitting at a distance. I use my arrow here to knock down the sheriff so we can push it. The Huntress comes at the top because she thinks that I was still there. I go for the headshot, of course. And that means that this is gonna be a 4v3 for a few more seconds. The second Huntress comes along and she tries to interrupt the cab, but it's a bit too late at this point. If I were to put this in short, it's basically take position away from your team but able to actually see your team and protect it. And also push in with your arrow or your flashbang only when you know that you are really needed. For example, I needed to knock down that sheriff. You have to know that in 1v1s that are close range, you are gonna lose most if not all of them. The idea is to keep range and just be as annoying as possible and try to go for the headshots, of course, but that comes with practice. Robin is a very strong character and a lot of people don't understand it yet, but he can deny a lot of the area of gameplay, like the chest areas and so on. So I think he's gonna be in a really good place once they figure out how to stop the flashbang bullshit and also like maybe change his passive a bit. Either way, this has been Nex. I really like making this type of guides and I think that there is a need for them, but I will try to cover every single class and I'm also thinking about starting to cover the maps and going over the details of the maps, like for example where the sheriff spawns and maybe some tips and tricks regarding all maps. Let me know what you think about this, and of course if you subscribe and comment and all that stuff, I will love you and I'll make love to you in the evening and get a pillow out of your face, and yeah, you get the idea.